Hello and welcome to Minecraft, episode 34 of my survival. Right, today we're listening to Kevin Wilson, so sit back, relax, enjoy the music as I do whatever I do on Minecraft. So yeah, enjoy.
Thank you very much. Mega fuckly. Sheilas, you know, if they didn't have a penny between their legs, they'd have a fucking bounty on their head. You know the ones that...
Jeez, a super mega fuckly with a moldy mango twist. Complexion like a pizza with warts and moles and zits. And just to even say a name, you gotta be half pissed, cause she's a super mega fuckly with a moldy mango twist. When she was born, the doctor slapped her mother in the mouth. And when they brought her home, they wouldn't let her in the house. And as she grew, it's sad to say, she just grew uglier. They tied some snags around her neck so the dog would play with her. Before she went to school each day, they had to iron her face. She'd get the cuts for coming early and merit points for coming late. And they had her portrait painted in six different shades of shit, cause she's a super mega fugly with a mouldy mung bean twist. She's a super mega fugly with a mouldy mung bean twist. Including her own mum and dad, she's never yet been kissed. And just to even say a name, you gotta be half pissed, cause she's a super mega fugly with a mouldy mung bean twist. When she puts on a lipstick, it keeps backing down the tube. And I've woke up screaming, dreaming that I'd seen her in the nude. When she sits on the beach, the tide's too frightened to come in. A sperm whale tried to root her last time she went for a swim. If they made an ugly meter, she'd blow the thing to bits. Under grotesque in the dictionary, there's a photo of her tits. And if I ever cracked a fat for her, I'd amputate me dick, cause she's a super mega fugly with a busted arsehole twist. She's a super mega fugly with a busted arsehole twist. Hell's Angels wouldn't root her, said they're not that fucking sick. So she bought herself a dildo, but she couldn't keep it stiff, cause she's a super mega fugly with a busted arsehole twist. She's a super mega fugly. Oh god, she's fucking ugly. She's a super mega fugly with a hanging hemorrhoid twist.
She said yes when he proposed. Now he finally get to fuck a woman instead of fucking gold. And the dean is getting his ass waxed for the wedding. Special gift for Spiros when needing those wedding bells. Athena's getting a badge waxed for the wedding. And her monobra, her mustache back and butt crack waxed as well. Athena had a young sister named Katrina. She was hot, sexy, slim and beautiful. All things Athena's not. One week before the wedding, when Spiros make a calling, parking bicycle against the fence and knocked upon the door. Young Katrina answered naked, he could not believe his luck. He smiled at him seductively, all he could say was,
fuck. Holy bloody fuck.
Then she whispered, Athena's getting to bash waxed for the special tip for Spiros when needing those wedding bells. Athena's getting a badge waxed for the wedding, and her monobrow, her mustache, packet, butt crack waxed as well. But Spiros spun around and started running towards the gate when Athena's mum and dad popped up shouting,
"Spiros, wait!
Young Katrina was just testing you, and now we know for sure you're the special man our family want to be our son-in-law." Again he wiped his brow and thought, "How lucky can I be? I was running to get condom hid beneath bicycle seat." You can clap hands for this bit. While Athena's getting a badge wax for the wedding, special gift for Spiros when needing those wedding bells. Athena's getting a badge wax for the wedding, and her monobrow, her mustache, back and butt crack wax as well. And her monobrow, her mustache, back and butt crack wax as well.
Latest buzzword buzzing round seems to be me too, and they're lining up with stories to tell about sexual harassment. Well, it's happened to me too. Fucking heaps of times, but mostly by myself. Wouldn't be a day goes by when I didn't grab me pecker around the neck and crank the living daylights out of him. Unwanted sexual advances? Maybe yes, maybe not. 'Cause I wanted it all right, but I'm not dumping myself in. Instead, I'm gonna start a movement called DIY too. After years and years of self-inflicted sexual abuse, not only am I victim, I'm the perpetrator too. So I'm gonna start a movement called DIY Me Too. To the point now where I just can't trust myself, but at the same time, I can't wait to be alone. Oh, I know what's gonna happen. I'm frightened yet excited. Can't take a shit or a shower without romancing the bone. Is it bragging or complaining? Is it my personal best or worst? My room's jack off central, but a crime scene as well. So should I send myself some flowers or a subscription to a new porn site? Or sue myself for a drum of KY gel? I'm confused. So I'm gonna start a movement called DIY Me Too. After years and years of self-inflicted sexual abuse, not only am I a victim, I'm the perpetrator too. So I'm gonna start a movement called DIY Me Too. I'm gonna start a movement called DIY Me Too. After years and years of self-inflicted sexual abuse, not only am I a victim, I'm the perpetrator too. So I'm gonna start a movement called DIY Me Too. I'm gonna start a movement called DIY Me Too. PC pushback song that I'd love for you to sing while we flip them PC fricks the finger singing FUPC. Fuck you, political correctness, FUPC. You're crippling free thinking and you're strangling free speech. The world's clipping you the finger, don't may break my bones, but words can never hurt. Armed with that and a dilly-gap attitude, my world just seemed to work. But them precious PC snowflakes take offense to everything we say. Millennial dyslexics, they read everything round the wrong fucking way. So I say, fuck you, political correctness, FUPC. You crippling free thinking and you strangling free speech. The world's coming to the finger, don't give a rat's ass what you think. Fuck you, political correctness, FUPC. Flip and sing. Fuck you, political correctness, FUPC. Have an opinion, can't say now what you see. You know what I see? A bunch of fragile soft cock fucktards. FUPC. Fuck you, political correctness. FUPC. You crippling free thinking and you strangling free speech. The world's flipping you the finger. Don't give a rat's ass what you think. So fuck you, political correctness. FUPC. That'd like to think that if I could go back in time, Banjo and Henry and even Ned Kelly would all be good mates of mine. Because they're pisspots, poets and outlaws, and I can relate to that. And I can relate to their attitude too, in a word, dillygaff. That's spelled D-I-L-L-I-G-A-F, dillygaff. And this is what it means. Do I look like I give a fuck, dillygaff? Am I being direct enough, dillygaff? It's just another way of saying I couldn't give a fucking rat's ass, mate. Do I look like I give a fuck, dillygaff? Your turn! Do I look like I give a fuck, dillygaff? You see, it's stress relief made easy. It's simple and it works. Just say dillygaff next time you gotta deal with dickheads, wankers and jerks. And when you go out, stick a dilly gap on your t-shirt or your hat. And when some cunt's giving you the shits, just say, mate, read that. That spells D-I-L-L-I-G-A-F, dilly gap. Do I look like I give a fuck, dilly gap? Am I being direct enough, dilly gap? Just another way of saying I couldn't give a fucking rat's ass, mate. Do I look like I give a fuck, dillygaff? Your turn! Do I look like I give a fuck, dillygaff? Do it again! Do I look like I give a fuck, dillygaff? Am I politically correct enough? Dillygaff! Just another way of saying I couldn't give a rodent's rectum, mate. Do I look like I give a fuck, dillygaff? Your turn! Do I look like I give a fuck, dillygaff? Big finish! Do I look like I give a fuck, dillygaff? Common sense ain't that common anymore. Seems common sense is past tense, just like the dinosaur. Political correctness has got a lot to answer for. Cause common sense ain't that common anymore. Political correctness, what a crock of shit. If it's political, it ain't correct.
Those two words don't fucking fit. Nor do military intelligence, friendly fire and holy war. But common sense ain't that common anymore. Words made up by academic fuckwits who hide in little fart-filled rooms, throwing random words together because they got fuck all else to do. Starts out as yuppie jargon, ends up fucking law, because common sense ain't that common anymore. Common sense ain't that common anymore. Seems common sense is past tense, just like the dinosaur. Political correctness has got a lot to answer for, because common sense ain't that common anymore. Words like illegal immigrant, is that a fucked up double or what? If you're an immigrant, g'day and welcome. If you're illegal, fuck off. And who's them low-life tow rags letting them sneak through our back door? Because common sense ain't that common anymore. Racist, there's one overused word that's laced with toxic venom, spat out by every do-gooder and minority group when you don't agree with them. Mate, this is Australia. One size fits all, but common sense ain't that common anymore. Common sense ain't that common anymore. Seems common sense is past tense, just like the dinosaur. Political correctness has got a lot to answer for, 'cause common sense ain't that common anymore. Petty crime, there's no such thing. Some poor bastard's gotta pay. Here's two words that just might work. Rattan Kane. We don't need a fucking police service. Bring back the police force, 'cause common sense ain't that common anymore. So all you soft-cock politicians, try getting your head around this. You're fucking up a great country, and we're tired of that PC shit. Try using a little more common sense. That's what we're paying you for. But common sense ain't that common anymore. Common sense ain't that common anymore. Seems common sense is past tense, just like the dinosaur. Political correctness has got a lot to answer for, 'cause common sense ain't that common anymore. Common sense ain't that common anymore. No, common sense ain't that common anymore.
Last year we went into Canada as part of this world tour, and it was quite interesting, because to go to different countries, you always got to apply for a visa and you also have to let them know what you do. And we always chase what we call an R rating, meaning that we'd hate kids to come to the show for very obvious reasons. So we always look for an R rating, and we applied for that in Canada, and they gave us the visa with the R rating on the show, which wasn't a problem. But then one of the guys from the consulate over there, he rang our office in Perth and said, look, can you tell Kev that we've given them the okay to go ahead with, but you can't say cunt in Canada. And I thought, fuck, you can in Australia. Fucking hell. So I thought, well, what a fucking ideal top name for a song. So we opened in Toronto in September last year, and this is the first song I walked out on stage with. You can't say cunt in Canada. Saying cunt's not very nice at all. No, you can't say cunt in Canada. So I asked the Sheilas what they called it. And they said muff, mut, minge, quim, twat, little flower, twinkle, tunnel of love. So if you're going to say cunt in Canada, you've got to say it with a velvet glove. And you can't say cunt in Canada. Here we go. No, you can't say cunt in Canada. So I thought I better ask the guys. And no, you can't say cunt in Canada. Why wasn't I surprised when they said gash, pussy, poontang, beef, curtain, burger, gateway to her guts? slogan when I wrote that one. Split whisker, beaver, long eye, front bum, growler, hairy lasso. Nah, you can't say cunt in Canada, because cunt's considered pretty fucking rude. No, you can't say cunt in Canada. So when I get to Montreal, if you're gonna say cunt in Canada, you gotta say it in French as well. So here goes Philippe Lacan, President Mitterrand, Pepe Le Pew. No, you can't say cunt in Canada. This cunt's considered pretty damn rude. And you can't say cunt in Canada.
In a song, I've had an absolute cunt of a day. Started as a fart in bed. Well, it started as a fart, but I shit myself instead. And the fucking missus going off her fucking head. I've had an absolute cunt of a day. And running to the dunny like a bastard. Trying to hold it in with me finger up me arse. Skidding past the kids and them little cunts laughing. I've had an absolute cunt of a day. I've had an absolute cunt of a day. Everything that could go did go wrong. So if I'm allowed to use the word cunt in a song, I've had an absolute cunt of a day. No hot water, had to take a cold shower. Scrubbing shit from every orifice took a fucking hour. Then fuck, 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 no fucking towels. I've had an absolute cunt of a day. Pulling on me jeans and tripped. Broke me fucking nose and split me fucking lip. Got me cock caught in me fucking zip. I've had an absolute cunt of a day. Help me! I've had an absolute cunt of a day. Everything that could go did go wrong. So if I'm allowed to use the word cunt in a song, I've had an absolute cunt of a day. Then driving myself to the doctor's. Busted and bleeding, cock swollen and throbbing. Not a good time to get stopped by the cops. I've had an absolute cunt of a day. Bastard didn't even let me explain. Just cut me up and hauled me off to jail. No fucking phone call, no fucking bail. I've had an absolute cunt of a day. Your turn! I've had an absolute cunt of a day. Everything that could go did go wrong. So if I'm allowed to use the word cunt in a song, I've had an absolute cunt of a day. So, Your Honour, that's how it is. That's exactly how it started and how it ended all up here. And you fucking lot laughing ain't making it too easy. I've had an absolute cunt of a day. And I'm in too much fucking pain to plead. And I don't give a fuck if you don't believe me. Just take me out the back and fucking shoot me, please. I've had an absolute cunt of a day. I've had an absolute cunt of a day. Everything that could go did go wrong. So if I'm allowed to use the word cunt in a song, I've had an absolute cunt of a day. I've had an absolute cunt of a, just another one of them, absolute cunt of a day. Nashville, thank you very much, it's great to be with you.
I first met him in the classroom back in 1963. We seemed to hit off pretty good. We were mates, Mick and me. He wasn't such a big kid even back then at the start. And he wasn't all that clever either, but Jesus, he could fart. I first found that out in class one day when things were going pretty slow. And just to keep us all amused, Mick let this fucking ripper go. You should have been there. Look, I'd describe it if I could. But I just turned around and I said, hey, Mick, you're fucking good. And at the inter-school grand final on the rugby field that time, we were getting beaten. They were 12 and we were 9 and played with 3 yards from our goal line when the referee called a scrum. And Mick said, don't worry, fellas, we've as good as got it won. So we just locked ourselves down in the scrum and we held each other's nose. And Mick, our little hooker, he let this fucking ripper go. It stung their nose and it burnt their eyes and it even scorched the grass. And I twigged right then and there, he had a double-jointed ass. Mick, me mate the master farter, put the art back into farting with his custom-tailored farts. Me mate the master farter, broke the ground in breaking wind with his double-jointed ass. And it was just a couple of years later, we both went to see Kamal. It was a really poshy sort of show in this great big bloody hall. And all the blokes were dressed like penguins. And you should have seen the sorts. And Kamal himself wore a Sheila's dress like a bloody black boy George. And we were all locked in there like sardines for the show to get underway. But the tuba player didn't lob. He'd booked off crook that day and Kamal said, without a tuba player, I cannot commence the show. So old Mick jumps up, said, Sambo, mate, I'll have a fucking go. Well, from then on in, I honestly thought that the whole show would be ruined. But he just winked at me and picked that tuba up just like he knew what he was doing. Then the maestro tapped his little stick to tell the band to start. Mick just shut his eyes and cocked his leg and then began to fart. Well, you could have heard a pin drop that night there in the hall. And it's hard to say who sounded best, Mick farting or Kamal. Then the audience just went apeshit. They cheered and clapped and stood. And Kamal smiled as if to say, hey, Mick, you're fucking good. Mick, me mate the master farter, put the art back into farting with his custom-tailored farts. Mick, me mate the master farter, with his true pitch-perfect calibrated double-jointed ass. Well, good news travels fast, it seems, and it wasn't very long before Mick got this midnight phone call from Ben Lexon and Alan Vaughn. They said, Mick, we got this specialist job and we're prepared to pay ya. Mick, old son, would you consider farting for Australia? We'll just prop you on our brand new yacht when there's no sea breeze blowing and get Mick the master farter, the starter, and keep the bastard going. So Mick went into training on sausage rolls and pies and Vegemite and Foster's beer and a scholarship from Heinz. The world had never seen before a yacht so finely groomed, or a crew so fit and young and strong, or an arse so finely tuned. The Yanks weren't even in the race, not even in the same class, what with Ben Lexon and his secret keel and Mick's fuel-injected arse. Well, he come back a bloody hero, didn't he? The All-Australian boy. And the government commissioned this bloke to do a big statue of his coin. And I can still see Mick standing there when they conferred his knight on. And Bob Hawke pinning it on, saying, hey, Mick, you're fucking good. Mick, me mate the master farter. Put the glass back into farting with his designer label farts. Mick, me mate the master farter. With his true pitch-perfect calibrated turbo-thrusted fuel-injected winds-protected double-jointed ass. I come from an outback town where fucking nothing grows. No wheat, no
no sheep, so we can't even boast an annual show. But we got something special there that sets our town apart. Cos each year in the shed we hold the Festival of Farts. There's displays and competitions and entries from afar. And those that can't get into town just send in little jars. And old Fat Sarge, the local cop, with clipboard and a pen, unscrews the lids, then takes a whip, then scores them 1 to 10. He'll give you 2 points for aroma, 2 for the bouquet, 2 for fermentation, and 2 more for decay, and 2 for presentation of the fancy little jars, and a medal for the best fart at the Festival of Farts. And you should see the mob this year that crammed into the shed. Hear the big guns blazing in the farting talent quest, with old Sarge on a megaphone as he reads the riot act.
Ah, settle down, you bastards. Can you hear me at the back? Now give them all a go, all right, and butt them cigarettes. And any of you cunts play up tonight, I'll bust your fucking heads.
Then he unfolds his director's chair and squats on his fat ass to adjudicate the entries in the Festival of Farts. He'll give you 2 points for aroma, 2 for the bouquet, 2 for fermentation, and 2 more for decay, and 2 for presentation, style and grace and class, and a medal for the best fart at the Festival of Farts. Then the crowd roars its approval as the first bloke lets one go, fucking thunder from down under to open up the show. Then a double burbling burglar with chilly afterburn. Then a downdraft nagger clang of shit that must have fucking hurt. And the silent singlet singer that took us by surprise, and a noxious nostril burner that brung tears to our eyes. And old Sarge, the cranky bastard, sat there adding up the marks, as popular as embroids at the Festival of Farts. Cos you'll get 2 points for aroma, 2 for the bouquet, 2 for fermentation, and 2 more for decay, and 2 for presentation, style and grace and class, and a medal for the best fart at the Festival of Farts. But the highlight of the show this year was 2 kids with a goat that they'd fed on rocks and rotten eggs and dragged in on a rope. And as one young fella grabbed his horns to line old Billy up, his mate just wandered round the goat's arse end, there kicked him in the guts. And that old goat fired a fucking beauty, like a shotgun going off, and fired a lethal load of gravel shrapnel, scared shit out of the mob. As they all died for cover, and if the deck in fear, old Sarge just kept on marking buckshot with them past his ears. He'd give them 2 points for aroma, 2 for the bouquet, 2 for fermentation, and 2 more for decay. And all in all, that bloated goat had probably scored a 10, except he farted, shit and shot old fucking Sarge arse overhead. Then with all of the confusion, and no cunt keeping score, and old Sarge fucking screaming, they just pissed off out the door. And even when the dust had settled, no one seemed to care that they'd fucked off with the medal, cause they'd won it fair and square. That goat got 2 points for aroma, 2 for the bouquet, 2 for fermentation, and 2 more for decay. And 3 big cheers from all of us for payback on old Sarge, and the medal for the best fart at the Festival of Farts. That goat got 2 points for aroma, 2 for the bouquet, 2 for fermentation, and 2 more for decay. And 3 big cheers from all of us.
Right, I'm going to end this video here. I'm going to say thank you very much for watching. Please like, subscribe, share, hit the bell for notifications, and we'll be doing a bit of deforestation in tomorrow's episode. And until then, I'll see you all again. Goodbye.